Hey, well, greetings, folks. Ed here again. My goodness, with my Austin allergies there. Yeah. Anyway, good to have you all today to learn about the amazing new thing that we're doing that I want to tell you about, having to do with this mobile app. So we're really stoked about it. I'm telling you, it has been moving really, really fast the last 2 weeks. Just I did a news announcement for some of the folks in our group out there, and so you all know about that. But we hadn't really announced it until just now, because we're ready to make something really happen with it. So I'm really glad you're here. And it's really not just the mobile app we're going to be talking about, but it's this concept of consensus trading. And I can tell you, in all my experience all these years, this has to be the safest, most consistent way to trade that I have ever seen or worked with, because it's all about, how the market is moving together, which is what it does, right? Pretty much the market goes up, most stocks will go up. Why does that happen? Market goes down, most stocks go down. Again, why? They didn't all lose value, or they didn't all gain value on a given day. So, it's a very interesting phenomenon that occurs, and it has to do with all the players out there buying and selling to take advantage of it and all that stuff. So it's super exciting, and I've got three really cool things to show you. Just checking. Looks like our sound is good. Thank you, Devin, so much for that. She's thinking ahead. Devin's always saving me out there. Okay, thanks, Eric. Awesome. Okay, Fort Lauderdale. Hey, well, welcome. Good to have you, Eric. Always good to see you on these things. Thank you, sir. Okay, so what I am, I'm over here. I've got a bunch of apps running, so give me just 1 second to make sure everything is ready the way I want it to be here. Give me just 1 second. Just queuing a few things up. Okay, that looks good. And this looks good. I think we are good. All right. So go ahead and queue my first slide. And I think we're ready. Okay. So consensus trading. This effort, what we're doing, if you go back to the email that I sent out, it's really about three things, okay, related to this: an OT version of it, a visual trader version of it, and the mobile app. They're all looking at the same concept, all taking advantage of the same theory, the idea of it. And the reason we're so excited right now is that when you look at these consensus moves, you're going to see, as I show them to you, they very clearly tell you what the market's about to do. It's really clear in the next few bars, at least, maybe the next 5 or 10, whether the market's going to be in an accumulation or a distribution mode. And of course, you can trade that, of course. So, why not be able to do it, wherever you are? So anyway, I'll get to that in a minute, but that's the exciting part about it. But let's go ahead and look at this concept of consensus trading and just kind of go over, the idea of it, the theory of it, and how it works. So here's a chart of gold miner ETF, GDX. And what we notice is that in any given exchange traded fund, which includes the market ones, right? QQQ, DIA, SPY, you have some stocks are leading, some stocks are lagging. But there's a certain rhythm that happens where they sort of all get together at the same time, and they're being accumulated, basically, that we get this leading indicator phenomenon. We can measure that. So this picture here, I've got three examples in GDX that were just happening while this move was going up. That was a great consensus trade, by the way. We picked that out a couple of weeks ago, and it's just phenomenal move on GDX and a few others. But here's three charts in here, and you can see they're all pretty much doing the same thing. This one is the strongest move. It's going past its resistance. This one's pretty good. This one's somewhere in the middle. And then you have some that are going flat, some maybe even going down. But when most of the energy is in that direction, then you get a really nice move. And so the concept is really pretty simple. What we do with this idea is we create this thing called the leading indicator, which is measuring all of that movement and combining it together to come up with one indicator that tells us what's happening inside the market. So it's not based on a chart, it's based on analysis of every single symbol in that market, in that ETF. Or market. If it's a QQQ, it'd be the NASDAQ market. But an ETF, it could be energy, it could be gold mining, whatever. So it's analyzing all of those. And what we do is, and this is the thing that I have a patent pending deal on, because it is new and it's something I think is really powerful. I was advised I should go do that, so I did. Really happy I did it. But it's based on two lines, and it's pretty simple, really. The green line is showing you a measurement of all the stocks that are going up. It's the upward consensus, right? And it goes from 0 to 1. When it's at 1, that means pretty much every stock in that ETF is just taking off. It's like really strong, like pegging the stops, you know, going. If the line is near 0, like here, the red line is near 0, that means almost nothing is going down. So go figure, you know, almost everything's going up, almost nothing's going down. You know, you just kind of expect this sort of thing to happen, you know, or this. I mean, it's the same thing on the downside. I've got the red is way up here, and the green goes down to 0, and you can actually trade this thing early as the green is going to 0 in the limit, as they say in calculus. As green goes to 0, sell, pretty much. And there you go. And here's a green going up on the right side here. And the same thing, as red goes to 0, you want to buy. So and there's several things about this that I've taught as how to interpret it, how to use it. And people have said, well, why don't you just make one thing that says buy and sell, like buy now, sell now. And the reason I didn't do that, and we kind of have that in VT with the leading indicator control that you'll see, but it really is about looking at what's happening. And so there's several things about this. It's how fast those lines are moving together and moving apart tells you the velocity of those symbols. That's important. How close that bottom one is to 0 is really important. And it's subjective, because it doesn't have to be at 0. It could be, you know, a little above 0, like right there. And that's still, you got this upward move. So you have to, when you make a thing that says buy or sell, you know, green light, red light, it's kind of a deal. You've got to make trade-offs. You've got to lock into something to say, okay, that's it. But it's nuanced a little bit, not hard to do, but it is looking, once you've looked at it for a little while, you start to really understand, oh, that's one of those, you know, that's really happening here. And so that's why I put the two lines on here. And then in VT, we have a little instrument that shows you what's going on. In OT, we have these little setup column chiclets that are colored based on the separation of these two lines. And I'm actually updating this right now to show velocity and to show proximity to 0 on the weak side. So there will be 3 in here pretty soon. And that'll just make it real easy to tell by looking at this list which ones have the 3 things you're looking for. So that's coming. Work on that right now. All right. So if we get a little more into this, the way the leading indicators are calculated for an ETF, exchange traded fund, is we are very fortunate to have Zacks in the program. It's like 10 bucks a month to get Zacks data. Well worth it, because they automatically update these weights in the ETF. So for example, here's one. Which one is this? Does it say? Is it XLE? I believe it is. It looks like it. Exxon, Chevron, Schlumberger, pretty sure. So Exxon is 23% of the weight of the ETF. So by movement, by amount, by, you know, the amount of, if you look at it, the amount of stock that's in that ETF, 23% of it is Exxon. And then 20% is Chevron, 5% is Schlumberger, and then it goes down from there. So we have a file, a spreadsheet built in that has all these weights in it that we captured when we shipped the product. And that's a way to use it. Or you can make your own spreadsheets, and you, or you can take some out if you don't want the lower ones, you know, whatever, there's things you can do. But the best thing is just to have Zacks updated, and then you don't need to worry about the spreadsheets. But they're there. There's a groups folder that has them for each ETF that we put out there. And so, you know, either way is fine. Okay, but we provide that capability. All right, just checking my notes here, my message. I've learned to look at my messages. When things happen, people tell me, and if I just look at this, I don't see them. So that's why I did that. Okay, all right, so let's go on down and look at the OT implementation, which is different from VT. OT has what we call a hierarchical focus list, and this borrows from the good old days of group trader. That's where it kind of came into being, and then we had ETF trader. And so this list down here, if you're on any of these ETFs, and there's 73 of them, they did a really good job picking this list, by the way. These are all liquid. They are pretty much all the industries, even the little bitty ones out there, like the AI industry is now an ETF, you know, things like that. So they're all in here, did a really good job. And if you click on any of them, you'll see the components and their weights down here. So there's a lot you can do with this. You can trade the stocks in here that are moving the most and one that you're, you know, that's doing this. And that's a really good strategy because the ETF, GDX, is like an index, right? It's got a lot of things in it. Some are going like this, some are going like that, some are going like this. So if you pick off the ones that are accelerated to the upside ahead of the move, they're leading that ETF, you've just got a better chance making money and making a lot more money because the percentage of the move is going to be much, much higher than the ETF. But you can do either one. For a little more, you know, diversity and safety, you can do the ETF. Returns will be less, or you can pick off the top three or four stocks out of that list down there. Look at them. Look at their technicals, you know, how they're set up. And there's certain things, you know, breaking through resistance, stuff like that, that's good. And trade those. So either is great. It's very, very easy. And of course, with OmniTrader, it was built from the beginning to be like you just push a button and it does everything. That was kind of the hallmark of OmniTrader. We first released it back in 93-4. And it's still, I haven't really seen any trading software that does that. You know, you have to do stuff to look at your charts. But so you, in the to-do list, you just say, you know, include the groups and perform selected tasks. And it will run the individual stock analysis on every stock in there. And then pull that together to create the leading indicator consensus signals that you see and the color that you see in the list. So it's all, you know, very easy to use, OT. Okay, so let's talk about setups. What we're looking for, and I kind of talked about this when I started, but basically it's like the acceleration, these lines separating, the two, the red and the green lines separating very quickly is good. This is a semiconductor ETF. When they're not separating very quickly, I call that the muddle zone, and you just don't trade there. So it's really helpful in avoiding this kind of stuff. But as soon as they separate, boom, you know, just like straight. Ideally, in one bar, you're going like halfway up this way and halfway down this way. That's a very strong consensus move that, you know, people out there that trade ETFs a lot, probably mostly institutions that buy them, are just jumping on that thing. So that's what you're really looking for. This is in this picture here, it looks to me like this is probably the best one, the strongest angle between those two. You know, the velocity of it, of the separation of these two, is the strongest right there. And that's really a good place to buy, it was right there. And the same, you know, going down, this is pretty good, not as good as that, but where the red gets above. And of course, this color coding is in OT. All right, so let's see here. So this is my summary slide on the OmniTrader version of this, is that this is what it is. It's got the top ETFs up here. You can sort on that. The top constituents of the ETFs, trade those individually. Then you've got the high and the low line, whichever it is. The high one is the direction you want to be. Excuse me. And that's it. So, you know, it's very easy to go through these and do a group rotation. Very, very easy, you know, to do that. So let's go ahead and go into my OT here and just kind of look at it for a second. So if I look at, so GDX is at the top of my list up here, I've sorted it. And if I double click that, what I'm going to see is probably something going up pretty fast, most likely. There you go. So we actually first signaled that. Look how beautiful that is. I was saying this a couple weeks ago, it was right here when I first noted it in a trading thing I did in our group that we hold weekly. And so, one of our members actually bought it, said, oh, it's good, I'm going to buy it, and he did, and, you know, it was really great. So silver is similar to this, SIL, and just took off. But you can see how clear this is. I mean, boom, boom, yeah. And as long as it, now here's a little hesitation, and the reason this line is on here, this is the trend break line, and we include this with OmniTrader and VisualTrader. It's part of what you get, because it is the way we're measuring the components to create the leading indicators with distance from this line. And so on the ETF itself, you get a little bit teeny pullback there and you go, well, it's still really, and this goes up a little bit. That means right there, you've got a little bit of a waffling. You know, they both kind of, well, wait a minute, we're gonna, you know, have some weakness, a little bit of weakness here and a little bit of strength here. But if I look vertically at that bar, there's nothing scary about that. It's not breaking this line, it's not getting weak, you know. This one right here is suspect because we're right at the line. That's going down. This is coming up. I just probably get out right there because, look, the red's coming up. I mean, you can wait till it breaks it, but it's right on that line. And that's why it's there. It's very, very good at telling you, you know, to stay with the trade or to get out of it based just on this chart. Okay, so that's GDX or QQQ is pretty green. Let's go look at that real quick. Green leading indicator. It's of course been pretty wild actually. So it is, you know, there's a good separation there happening. That looks like the start of a move. And actually I was wondering about that because it was green. I go, wait a minute, that there's no big angle there. Well, it hadn't updated this column yet. So I need to run the to-do list. So it updates all these. Anyway, we won't do it right now, but that should be like a yellow is what it is, because it's just a little separation. So we need to wait a little bit on that one. Now, these are probably similar. Let's look at XLK, which is the technology ETF, see if it changes color. It's one of these things. You've seen your signals come up in OG, right? If you didn't get the data before. So, and I thought I did it, but yep, that's yellow too. Okay, so XLK, very, very similar, just a little green right there coming up a little bit. Here, back here, it was nice, you know, and back here, it was nicely separated. Kind of a volatile ETF, I would say, but it's working just fine when these things separate and move apart pretty good. That is a good move. Okay, so let's see, we'll do one more here, XLC. And like I said, I'm don't change color, just stay green, please. It's not gonna listen to me. It's gonna do what it wants. There it is, yellow. Okay, so it looks like we're in kind of a transition mode here because these are very close together. Red's coming up, so you know that looks just those three symbols we clicked on right now look kind of like the market could easily just sort of go down there. So okay, but if I could find a good one, then I would go down here and sort on these guys. There's the red. Here's the green, and then. Again, this is probably going to change color on me, but I'll plot it anyway. So there's, not bad. Okay, so this is, you know, that's a pretty good pattern for a buy, if the group was bullish, but it's not. Let's look at this one. That's Google, and you know, it's up sideways. It's okay. It's a light green, not a dark green. So it has not updated. But anyway, I could go through them and find the ones. You know, if I took some time to do it here, but I'm going to reserve that for my training that you'll learn about in a little bit. But it's really pretty easy. Just go through them, look at the constituents, pick two or three. Good. That's it. So OT is very straightforward, very simple to use. This group thing down here can be brought up or taken down, and you can sort on, you know, signals coming out of it. Signals are based on breaks of this line here on the individual stocks. On the ETS, they're based on the leading indicator separation. That's what the signals come from. So, but it just kind of does both of them. So this is the first product we've had where it's actually running in two modes. When I look at a stock, I see the thing that's generating the signals. When I look at an ETF, I see the leading indicator and the coloring of that. So, you know, I can easily pick it out. Okay. All right. And for some reason, my color chart just went away. Why? Don't know. Anyway, that's weird. I hadn't seen it happen before, but it did. But I can easily put it back in there. It's defined in the documentation. It's really a guide. It shows you when they're a certain distance apart, like a 0.2. This is 0 to 1 here. So when they're about 0.2 distance, then it'll show that color. So I'll have to get that back on there. Okay. So that is OT. And as I had said, you know, this concept, after using it, I've been working with it for about a year, actually working with the Inner Circle on it. And it's a lot of those guys that are in there will tell you, they've just seen me do blog posts out the wazoo on using this thing and all kinds of tests with it. So we've made a lot of progress in the past year, but I think it's just special enough that I've applied for a patent on it. And I think I'll get it because it is a very unique thing in the marketplace. And so provisional patent, and then of course those get converted later into real patents once they come up, actually, you know, press for that. But so this is, haven't done this very often. We did it for Visual Trader on the cylinder concept, the way it works, and we got that patent. And so this is the second one I filed, and that's how much I think about it. It's pretty awesome. All right, a multi-line consensus indicator for measuring internal market strength is what it is called. Okay. Very good. So now let's move on. That's OmniTrader. Let's look at ETF consensus in VisualTrader. So VisualTrader was really kind of designed with this idea in mind, because it is based on, as you know, these plates that have groups on them. Let me go and take OT down here. I should have ET right behind it. Yep. So if I were to, you know, take that away, you'd see what VisualTrader was kind of originally based on, which is these plates with stocks on them. And each one of these is an industry ETF, and it's the direction series, XLY, XLI, XLK, XLU, XLV, XLC, and so on, XLE. So each one of these has the stocks that are in that. And, you know, VisualTrader is pretty far ahead of its time when we made it. But this organization really lends itself to some amazing things. Let me go ahead and bring up QQQ here. And let's look at it. We've had a very wild day. This is 1 minute chart. QQQ has just really kind of gone sideways. And so just taking advantage of looking at it right here, I want to point out a couple of things. First off, what you're seeing across the top there is each of those ETFs and what is happening inside of them. Now just think about how powerful that is. So like I know here's XLP. I'm going to click that one. And we know that's going on because it's got a green arc. So when you look at this thing, the way you interpret it is the green and the red, those two lines are above and below the center line. That's like however much green there is that there. And here's one has a lot of red. However much red there is, it's that. This one has a mixture. There's kind of red below and green above. All right. The arc that you see is from zero horizontal. It is the combination of these two. It's actually like a sum of the plus and the minus to get an intermediate value. So if red is at zero, like right here, okay, where this thing is just taking off like a mother, you're gonna have that arc, a great big green arc like here, okay? XLP, well, that's what's going on to the right. Look at this. If I zoom in right here. So XLP, it has been in a bullish mode from there. So obviously buying it right about there would have been a good idea. So here we go, all the way up here, we're bullish as horseradish right here, just taking off. And so there's so many ways to use this. I'm gonna show you the way that I'm gonna use it with the mobile app when we get to that. But there's so many ways to do it. You can go into these individual ETFs and trade them or trade their components, just like with OT. And the difference is the list is over here. So let's see, let me go down, let me find, which one is this, XLP. So I can find it down here, XLP is this guy. And I see that small writing, sorry. Procter & Gamble is the strongest stock in that list. And they're all positive. You can get some that are a little bit behind the major move. And that one's just going anyway. So you can trade these individual stocks very easily, or you just trade the ETF. So, you know, I click on it again, I'll get the ETF. And it just kind of depends on what you're doing, what your philosophy is about trading. Do you want to be more diversified in a trade, or do you want as much movement as possible? Because the ones internal to that, let's just look at this here. We've had from there, it's gone from like 75 to 75.9, which is about 1%. But if I click on some of these guys, you know, see 150, because that's about 1% also. If I click through all of them, I'm going to find a couple that are much more than 1%. But you get the idea. I have to kind of go through them and check them out here. Okay, anyway, we'll do that. But so they will move because the ETF is an average of all of them. They're going to move faster, of course. All right, so that's XLP, which is our biggest, baddest, most bullish ETF right now, closely followed by XLK, which is, let's see, that is technology. If I should have done that, didn't have to look at it. All right, so technology crossed over here, the red and the green crossed right there. We crossed our line, which is, you know, plotted in these charts just like it is in OT. And so, you know, right there, as that was gaining strength, would have been a good place to get into that ETF. And let's see, there's some others here that are more mixed. XLI kind of has both going on, but it crossed right there and it's going. Okay, now, let's talk about the way I like this thing. And I've been doing this, okay? I'm looking, if I had a move right now, I'd do it, but we'll just see what we've got here and look at it. I want to trade the QQQ. And the reason for that is it's so flexible. So let me click on the QQQ here. We actually have that as a group. And so we're in a bullish mode right now. It's likely to go higher because these are separated pretty good. But if I think about what, you know, what this represents, it is the market of the NASDAQ. It is 100 stocks from mostly technology, but it's kind of scattered around. And so what if I were to look at the other markets themselves to confirm this? So I have within those stocks, I've got the leading indicators showing me what they're doing inside there, inside the QQQ. But I've got this picture up here. It's like a dashboard, you know, an airplane, a car, however you want to, analogy you want to use. And if you see all of those things going green, like really quickly, it's like, man, off to the races. Now, there's a really good thing about that VT has. We're just going to look at it real quick here. I want to go back, see if I can catch it doing this. Let me find a really strong move, and I'll just show you here. Let's go back. I can actually go back in time to any point I want and see what those things look like. So this is great for learning about it. Oh, I know what I want to do. So this morning, it was just beautiful. Look at this. You see how this separation is kind of boring? Look at this right here. I mean, so let me go back to there. Let's just look at it real quick, right where that was going on. Keep going. Come on. Let's go. I could grab the slider, but I'm pretty clumsy. And yesterday afternoon, oh my goodness, that was just worth. Look at this. Separates. Just worth a lot. Okay, there we go. Red is all the way pegged there, and it starts happening. So red goes all the way to the top. Let me open this up a little bit. Let's see where it does that. It does all the way right about there. Now, when you're looking, and I need to open it this way so it stays with me. Okay. Now, yeah, we got a big red bar there, but that says everything is going down. Everything in that ETF is going down. And we look up here and we see, look at our ETFs, and we go, well, you know, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are doing the same thing. They have a strong red arc. They are going down pretty hard. Not all the way, but pretty hard. So I go, well, okay, I'm going to let this develop a little bit. So I go next bar. Okay, and let's just watch what happens to these guys as we go forward. Okay, so it's got a little bit of mixture there. Okay, this one now is fully pegged down. That one's fully pegged down, fully pegged down. These two are bucking the market. Let's look at them real quick. So the consumer staples and the utilities, those two, and they're kind of defensive industries. So they are rallying. So we have a rotation happening from more of the tech stocks and energy stocks into the consumer stuff. Let me go ahead and go back to the QQQ ETF here, and we'll just go for a little bit more. Okay, a little bit more. Now I've got really solid red, almost no green. And I'm just looking to see here. Okay, still watching this. That rotation is still very strong into those stocks. There we go. So now XLP is solid down, XLK, XLE, XLC. So I was thinking that they all turned with it yesterday, but or this morning, but apparently it was most of them did, but not all of them. But when you see a consensus of, you know, across all of the industries that are in here, one way or the other, that's a really strong sign that that market is going down. Really, really, really strong. So here we go. So now I've got all but one is down. So, and this is fully pegged up, fully pegged down. So there you go. You could get in here. There was a good case for getting in here because that was so strong and you had the defensive groups going up. What I've been doing is going back in time like this and just looking at how this looks right before a big move. I wish I had time to do it here, but making test cases for my education, I'll be doing on it. Because there, I have noticed that for example, XLP and XLK seem to lead the moves most of the time. Like they will go before the rest of the industries go in a direction. But this, the dashboard there is just so amazing, you know. And if something's going opposite, like XLE energy is in a rally right here. Well, there's probably a reason for that. So you could do a hedge. You could do, you know, long XLE, short QQQ, for example. But let's go forward a little bit more here and just kind of follow it through. XLE is still, and as I imagine I'm in this trade going along, and I have this comfort level. I'm just like feeling so good because I've got my little tool down here that's telling me, no, it's still weak as heck. Every stock is going down in this thing. Think about that. Every stock in that ETF is going down pretty hard. So, you know, am I really worried about that chart just turning around on me and going up? It can do it. Things can happen, like suddenly in the market, Powell says something, you know, we've all seen that, whatever, it can happen. But just in a normal market, you just don't worry about it because it's like, you know, so even though I got that, let's go forward here, see if it's gonna make a liar out of me. Okay, now what we see here is that these are starting to back off. So what I do, I go up and I look at the rest of my markets and I see that they're all still pretty much down. Let's go forward here. And just kind of watch, see what happens with it. Okay, so we got a slight upward move there, and now they are coming back together right here. So that was the first thing we saw where it was starting to come back, but now these are moving back together. So we have to watch. I still have negative sentiment up there, and so let's keep going. Okay, and typically what I'll do is exit on the cross of this line. Now they've come back together, and now we're in the muddle zone because it's gone below, like about the third middle ground of this is kind of where those lines are. So we had good consensus move here and here, and then it started to go the other way. But so that move, you know, from there to there is pretty good. Now, the other reason I like to trade the QQQ is that we have these leveraged ETFs that are really fantastic to trade. Let me click on the TQQQ here and let it load. I'll go back to QQQ so you can see it. So it really is the same chart. It is a triple leveraged ETF, but for every percent the QQQ moves, this will move 3%. So you can get in a day, you can get 2-3% moves really pretty easily, consistently, as long as you know, you get on one side of the market that's going down like that, use your consensus to help you stay with it, and then you know, so that's from this move was actually, so two, every 2% is two points here. So, every percent, sorry, so that's one, two, that's down to there is about 2.5% move on that instrument. And it's very liquid. The spreads on this thing are like one penny all the time. So if, you know, you're trading a retirement account or something, they're great. If you're trying to go short, like in this case, we don't want to short TQQ because we are in a retirement account. So you just buy SQQ instead. Excuse me. So when leading indicator is telling you over here that we're going down, the market's going down, you're buying SQQQ. And then again, watching for your clues as to maybe getting out early or waiting for it to cross that the line that I've selected, which is very, very good in these charts. And you can kind of see that just looking back, you know, so here TQQQ was going up. That was that rally yesterday, and you know, nice steady move. It wasn't like screaming up, but it was very steady, green above red all the way from there to there, and then red above green all the way from the open, actually, down to there. So we're crossing that pretty much. Okay, so as far as the current market goes, let's just see where we are again and look at it. So it's mixed. I mean, if I were just sitting in front of and trading, because I'm not, I'm on the webinar, but if I was sitting in front of this trading, you know, make sure I'm on the edge there. No, it's because of this. Hold on. I'd gone back in time. So very, very choppy market today. You see, these are pretty low, both of them. They're kind of trading places, but they're low, except this one gets up pretty high. That's a rally there, but they're just kind of together right in the zone. So now that I'm actually on the right edge, which I wasn't, I can see that I've got almost, you know, every ETF is strong except for XLE. So I wish webinars went longer. This stuff moves so slowly, but I could take a position on the TQQ here as it turns up because again, all, you know, every ETF is strong. This is not a very good trading market. Obviously, you want to have something that is more directional like this, you know, and that is that leading indicator tells you that's happening because it gets so strong in one direction or the other. Here it's not. So I'm just going to be trading right now to trade, which we can do, but you know, it's gonna kind of waffle in here. This doesn't have conviction. Yeah, let's see here. Yeah. Okay. So what I have been working on, the technique that I'm really so excited about, is looking for times when all of these things are pegged. And actually this morning I didn't study it. I was of course working on this webinar. So I noticed that we did have some counter trend groups here. So, you know, I would have waited until I got like that five consensus that we saw, but just wait until pretty much every market group is positive and going up. And this one right here is all of these symbols, like every symbol in this list is this main guy. And so he's going to pretty much kind of be an average of all of these, but I'm just looking for, do I have it? And especially if they're increasing. So those arcs are moving up, like, you know, up like this, then you've got the makings for the start of a really good move. And of course you want this to be really strong, this to be really weak. And then you just hang on once you get into one of those. I like this trend break line because it is very good at stopping you out. And if you're wrong on the trade, like there, we're just back and forth in here. So if you were trading this, even though it's not very strong, you see the exits are really close to the entry points. Like, I'll pick a place. Like if you got in short right here, this is going up like that. You got in short and you stayed with it, you'd be doing pretty good. And then it would go through at about the same level right there. So it's kind of like that. All these trades they're very close in terms of crossing from where this starts. So starts going up, you know, and then it crosses there, which is almost the same level. So even though today was this massive sideways day, that particular exit technique is really good. It really, you know, keeps you going. Okay. All right. We're gonna have a little time for Q&A here. So we need to get to the mobile app, which is the whole the title of the star of the show. So, but we have done this first, you know, we have OmniTrader, which implements it one way. VT implements it another way with these little indicators that are going up and down to tell you, you know, when you get a consensus. So we basically took that, those concepts, and said, let's make a mobile app that shows you exactly this picture with the chart. So you could just, because that's all we're looking at is leading indicators in the chart to decide to place a trade. So every now and then, and it's like, I think three times a week, the market just goes boom. It just takes off one way or the other. And those are the ones that are just the monster moves that make a huge amount in a short period of time. So I don't want to be looking at this all the time. I want to be doing, you know, whatever, my life. And I've got the phone will say, hey, it's happening. Okay, so that's our segue then to, there's VT, which we just looked at. All right. And here is that strong and the weak on the index itself. And so actually, let me go back on this. Yeah. So this is what that picture looked like this morning about there. Okay. Anyway, I just went past that. But that's what you're kind of looking for, is that everything is red and going down, which was the condition when it's right on the right edge right here. Anyway, so that's VT. So what we did is we took all of those things and put them into this mobile app, or that was the idea for it. We started working towards how do we make a mobile app. We'd never done it before. A lot of research on that, finding the right person to help us. We did. And actually, you may know Steve on our staff, Steve Mayo, here with us, as knew someone he had worked with, and he told me about him. So this guy is really good. So we got with him and started working on creating this mobile app. And I'm going to show it to you here in a second. This is sort of the drawing of what it would look like. So you can see all of those ETFs are there. And so it's very easy to look at this and tell, along with the chart, along with leading indicator, what's happening. You know, is it ripe for a move? And that's really it. That's what it does. So we think, you know, it's the kind of thing. And really the original genesis of this was we need Nirvana systems. We need to get out into the public, into the trading public with something exciting, something that can catch on. And so my feeling is that this is so accurate so often that whoever has it, you know, if they can see, you know, one market to start with, whatever, they'll want to look at it. So that's really what started the whole mobile app thing, was, hey, let's do something that can get, you know, leads for the company and get people to come to us and look at what we have. Because if you just go try to advertise something like Visual Trader or OmniTrader, the cost of doing that against all the other platforms out there is just really, really high. So this is, that's kind of the origin of let's make a mobile app. One thing led to another. And now what I sincerely believe is that when I have this, I will be able to trade with it randomly in the market when those things happen, when, you know, when something like this move happens right here. And just, there it is, do it. So, you know, we'll have trading capability will come into this and all of that. So it's really super exciting. And so let me go ahead and see if I can show it to you. This is a web page version of it, which is okay. It's a web page, so it doesn't really look like a phone, but I can show you here. Okay, there we go. Yeah, make sure that's on there. All right, there it is. Okay, so here's your markets. Here's the QQQ, and then here's the leading indicator right here, which is currently going up. There's a chart here. So again, this is a prototype. I was going to actually go to my phone and bring it up on there because it looks so much better. And let me just see if I've got that link here. I can do it and show you on the camera there. Okay, here we go. There we are. All right, let's see what happens here. Yep, there you go, we're on the phone. So hoping you can see that with that camera, but hopefully, but anyway, that's it. So this is the prototype. We just got this out of the oven a few days ago. And so now this developer is actually encapsulating it for delivery to iPhone and Android. And the only market hooked up right now is the one on the left, QQQ. The others are just placeholders. But where we're going is for this picture you see on your screen there. In fact, this is what I need to do. I mean, think about it. One second. There we go. Much better. Okay, now you can see me full screen. So there you go. That's mobile app. So what we're doing now is taking this to the next level, adding the other markets and getting it into, you know, a releasable form so that those who come on board with us on the consensus trading applications that we're promoting right now will just start, you know, get the first app very soon. Could be a week. We think it's sometime like that. We need to work out the data collection part of it. But once we have that, we're going to release it to everyone who's on this. And then as we make the improvements, we add, you know, multiple markets, like all those ETFs, and then finally trading, all those things. And you'll also be able to eventually drill down to see the individual stocks inside the ETFs. So we've got a planned sequence of improvements. We'll just keep doing it, pushing it out. And again, so this we're doing right now is just an early release. And I'll tell you why in a second. But the goal is to get this out and then get uptake with it, you know, out in the world. So that's the Nirvana reason for making the app in the first place. But I was thinking, you know, this is so much fun and interesting and powerful that I bet a lot of our customers would want to come on board with us and do this. And so that is what we're here today to talk about, in addition to all this other stuff. So we have looked at these three different forms of leading indicator, the OT version, which is great for end of day work, fantastic for group rotation, Visual Trader, which is end of day and real time. So I didn't click the daily time frame in VT, but it's also very good, just like OT, same thing. And it's, you know, you can see all the symbols there stacked up. So it's, and see them just by themselves. And so that's a little more capability to do that. And then of course, this is what we're going for, is the mobile app. So go back to the screen here. And that is the goal, have that thing and just be able to trade these ETFs when they move from anywhere. All right. So like I said, the impetus for us is, you know, we need to improve our customer acquisition with something. And we've looked at all different ways to do it. There's a lot of projects going on in here. We are doing, working with the Inner Circle. We have Trade Gnosis, fantastic, you know, AI-based system that Steve Mayo came to us with. So there's projects going on, and those are here. They're with us. We're not out trying to market those. out there anywhere at this point, but this is the one that we think can get us, I want to say viral, like I don't know if I've got the right term, but that's what we think will happen when traders, especially like your Robinhooders, you know, show me a trade, I want to trade something. You know, sorry, didn't mean to, but I just, there's a picture of a guy in Reddit, you know, saying, what's going up? What's happening to GameStop? You know, anyway, so they can just look at this thing and be alerted when they need to be looking at it and then get some successful trades with it. So that's the whole idea of this. So we have to, you know, I have to turn the ship towards it. It's this thing of getting all the firepower behind it. My developers, you know, marketing, I mean, everybody's on this right now. And so what we decided to do was to announce it to you guys, let you know what we're doing, and offer this opportunity for you to come on board. And I call it a crowdfunding event because while we are selling a product, basically, and you actually get three, you get everything we're doing with this, the purpose of it specifically is to give us the fuel to go through these versions and really get it done, get it out there in the mainstream. So it's that the problem of, you know, just being able to actually do that. And so I thought, okay, what can I do that's really good to make this happen for our folks that want to participate? And so here's what I came up with. And I do think it's amazing, actually. This is the website, which is /CTA, nirvanasystems.com/CTA. And that stands for Consensus Trading Apps. Consensus Trading Apps is what it means. So here's what we're doing. We're bundling all of this stuff into one thing, okay? And I didn't mention this, but we have a real-time version of this thing for OmniTrader, where you get the same display with the ETFs and the stuff inside them in real time. But there are some internal latency issues with the data, so it can get behind in OT, not VT, but OT. And so we're working on that. But that is included in this. So basically, is the first thing on here is the mobile app. It should be the last thing, but the first early version of the mobile app, you just be able to get it, put it on your phone, you'll get it. It will be in the App Store fairly soon. You can get it from there once it's there, but before that, we'll have a way to download it. You can do that with apps, and so you can get it. And then in the general market, what we're going to do is say, you know, it's $5 per ETF per market, because the powerful thing is to have all of them. See that consensus? So that's like, it'll be like 30 of them, so 150 a month, but we're thinking 100 maximum. This is just where we are right now. So we're going to include that for a year. Also, ETF Consensus Trader for OmniTrader and the real-time version. So the real-time version is being worked on right now. It will happen, but right now it's the end-of-day version for OT, for OmniTrader. Visual Trader is both, real-time, end-of-day, which, you know, you saw that. That's VT supports both. Well, it was designed for that. And then also I'm going to do these special education sessions starting tomorrow morning. So this is going to be in the email tonight that I put out, that it's going to start tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. We'll just see what's happening in the market for about an hour. And I'll be there and show you what I'm seeing, what's happening. And so we can see if we can actually trade it in the morning. So I'm going to do about five sessions on that. And so, and these are the, what we charge these things. The Visual Trader version has not been released ever of leading indicator. It's brand new. It has that powerful display across the top dashboard. So selling that in the open market, which we're not releasing it to the open market yet, we're just delivering it to folks who do this with us, we would charge $14.95 for that. It's worth a lot more than that, probably $3,000, because of how powerful it is. And, you know, folks will be seeing that as we use it. But so if I add all these up, it's like over $3,500 in value. And so I was thinking, let's not price it like that. You know, we could say it's $3,000 per person. Yes, people would do it. But I said, let's make it where it's, you know, enough. We can get to where we need to get to, but it's low enough that folks go, sure, I'll participate with this, you know. And so it's $9.95. That's it. And there's no discounts beyond that discount. It's just $9.95 for everybody. And you'll be part of this, you know, mobile app, really, group of people who are looking at this with us and helping us with enhancements. It'll have a notification button on it, so you can set up the notifications that you want, and other features that we think will be very desirable. But we want to get feedback with surveys with this group, this focus group of people doing this with us. So two purposes. One is to fund it. And if we can get to about 200 of these out there, we've got it. We've got it. We've looked at the projected, you know, the development effort required to get, you know, the, all those markets in there, and configuring it for notifications, the trading part of it as well, at least going to IB, possibly others. We're looking into that right now, but at least it would be IB. And so, you know, with that kind of an event, a 200 person uptake on this, we think we've got it. And that's really what it is. That's what we're doing. And again, I know you guys have supported us all these years, your purchases of our products and other things that we've done. Just really appreciate you. This is the importance of this for us is getting into the market, you know, back out there and growing our customer base, which we need to do. But also, I want to trade this thing. I mean, I want to have it tell me, hey, the NASDAQ is taking off, because I have seen these events. They happen. And, you know, I was in the inner circle trading them a couple times and doing videos about that. It's just like so exciting, because when it happens, it's just so clear that everything is going up and you just see that. So to have the phone tell you, you know, that yes, that's going on right now. And you go, okay, and you look at the index, look at the other markets, looks good to me. You place the trade, ideally with a trade plan, you know, so you have to keep watching it, but that's another level of change we have to add to it. But then you're just tracking it and trading it right there on your phone, wherever you are, or you know, iPad, whatever it is. So I'm personally kind of excited about that, because I have been working with this thing for a long time and I've missed a lot of those. I missed the one yesterday, which was so clear. I mean, my goodness, look at that chart. It's like, oh, just beautiful consensus move, the upside. So anyway, so I'm excited about it for that reason. So hey, I'll go ahead and take some questions here. We're just about 5 minutes left on the hour, but I can stay a little longer if I need to. Happy to do that. And again, it's very exciting. I just appreciate you guys and hope you decide to come on and join us and help us reach the first time ever, you know, Nirvana mobile app. And oh, by the way, I didn't mention this, but web is the side product. It's very easy because of the way we're making the app. It's basically HTML5 technology. It will be amenable to a web page version, which will look kind of like VT, you know, have the big chart on it and the different markets and a list. So it'll, you know, be that same presentation that you see in OT and VT with the list on the left and all that. But basically we just reconfigure the mobile app with some, you know, some changes, and it'll then be a web app. And I didn't really talk about that in this presentation, but that's just, we have to do that. They have to have, you know, it's just better to have more real estate when you're trading, you can see more things. So it's helpful. And some people will want to do that. If they're trading, they've got 10 monitors around them. I've seen these on the internet, people that do this. And so let's assign one to bleeding indicator. And, you know, when it beeps, I'm going to take notice of that market. So it'll get traction there too. But so we need a web version. And I didn't mention that, which I should have. Okay. So let me look here. I'm going to look at this. Okay. Let's see. Oh boy. Pamela. Hey, Pamela. It says, I only see a black screen. My goodness. I hope that wasn't. Okay. You say you see it now. Good. Scared me. I got a heart failure here. Okay. And Pamela says, also looking forward to good Android alerts. Count me in. All right. Oh, count me as one of those Robinhood people. No, I think it's exciting. I mean, what's happened with that traders with the pandemic getting on that thing? I was just kind of making fun of the GameStop people when that happened, but anyway, they all kind of piled on. But yeah, it's exciting, and it's a, you know, the trading has exploded. I guess to more of a younger crowd, like the, you know, the 30-ish sort of age group, and I know they're having a lot of fun with it and really getting a lot out of it. So no disses on Robinhood intended. Okay. All right. So Eric's asking about the OmniTrader ETF consensus. It is the product that we released a little while back. That's one of the components of this. That's included in this that I showed. And then Pam says, I just can't sit in front of a screen all day. I hear you. But I mean, No one does, right? You do it something. So it's just so much better if you just have it, like, hey, it's happening. And the other thing about the mobile app that we've of course talked a lot about it as we're working on it internally here, is that it opens itself up. It's a new frontier for us because we're doing AI based signals in real time. We can do that with our GA and the other components we have. You know, other things, other ways to generate alerts and signals on the market that we've been working on for a long time. So we can deliver anything in this app that we want. And so the progression is get this out, get it working, get it helping us, and then start adding the other things that make it more of a trade delivery, idea delivery application beyond the leading indicator, where people can choose, I want to subscribe to these particular signals, or, you know, whatever it is that we have. So we haven't, of course, gotten to that. We're really focused on making this work first and just consistent trading. But, you know, we now clearly see it's just not that hard to add other kinds of alerts in. So it's exciting. Okay, and Eric says, a technical question, sort of. What are the signals in OmniTrader, Visual Trader based on? So the one I showed you, I'm going to bring it back up here, the VT is, let me see here, let me go to something as a signal in it. Okay, so these are just, in this particular one, it's just volatility breakout signals, which are really pretty good for trading, you know, the start of a move. In OmniTrader, they are trend break line signals. So when the trend break two crosses the trend break five, for the stocks, for the ETF, it's the separation of the lines. So when these separate a certain amount on the ETF, then it will fire a signal in OmniTrader. That's how that's designed. Okay. All right. Let's see. All right. Eric's saying, when will the VT version be available? Okay. OT is great, but VT will be even better. Hey, Eric, good news. It's here. There it is. So they just have to package up this profile and the indicators that I'm using, which Barry said, you know, this webinar came up really quickly, so he couldn't get it before the webinar, but like this evening, he'll have the files. And so this will be in the dashboard to download the VT version. And I know you're a big VT fan. That's great. But yeah, this is exactly what you see here with these industry groups, all configured, ready to go. So you can start, you know, checking the market out. I'm still watching here. We're at what, 2 o'clock now? So we've got generally down across here. Let's look at what's happening. And so we see that reflected right there in the QQQ. Still not quite. I mean, we're really looking for things like this, you know, to just go. And I was hoping what would happen during the webinar, but it hasn't. But so we've had, you know, you can see that was pretty tradable though, with the crossover, the weak stocks, many, many more of those than the up stocks, the down stocks versus the up stocks. And so somewhere in here would have been a good place to take a trade and then look at getting out of it as this turns back the other way. So there's various ways to use it. Quite a few trades like that in through here, but this one was pretty strong, pretty strong angle on that, moving up pretty fast. So I'll go ahead and leave it up here so we can kind of watch it and see what these guys do, or markets over here. Anything, yeah, there's kind of up a little bit, these three ETFs. This one's down pretty hard, but it's, yeah, but not all the way. So there's just kind of weak, but not going straight down, which is what we want to trade it. Okay, back to Q. So yeah, this is one of those sort of muddy zones right here. Okay, given the consensus across the top. All right, let's see here. Okay. Eric says, I noticed the 1 minute time frame, but I've seen you use 5 minutes before real time. I like the 5 minute time frame because the moves are longer. Let me see, do I have it here? Go ahead and go to it. That's one thing. If you do select a time frame, it'll just adjust everything, that time frame. So this is in 5 minutes, and here's what our consensus looks like in 5 minutes. And so we had a very strong negative. We saw that when I was first bringing it up and going through it right there. So that was great. So when you're trading the higher time frame, you're going to have higher drawdowns typically. You know, in this case, if you stay with this line to get out, then not really. You're just going all the way over to here. But if you're trying to look at what's happening to get out early on a move, then the 1 minute is just crisper. In fact, 100 tick charts are even, more control. You can just see what's going on here. I've got the daily here also. So I go to daily, and this thing just kills it in daily. I mean, you can see that. So green above red. It's really, really predictive. Right there. Here's the red signal coming in right there. So, but that's daily. So you can use this in daily mode too. And we see, these ETFs are poised to go up here in daily. There's that move on XLP taking off. Everything's going up right now in XLP in the daily chart. So XLF, sorry, XLF, financial sector. But it's just a great roadmap. You know what I mean? It really helps you to see what's happening. Indicators in the chart, just they're not the same. This is the components that are in there. So it's just a much clearer picture of what's happening. Okay. Let me see if there's any more here. All right. Okay. Yeah, Don, let me write you on that one or send me an email. I'll ask you kind of a longer question. Let me answer that privately with you. Okay. I think that is it for the webinar. Okay. Well, gosh, thanks, folks. Again, what I said, I like inventing things, coming up with new ways to trade, new ways to approach the market. You've seen us do all these different kinds of things out there over the years. For the last 3 years, I had some marketing people that were with me for a while, and they kept saying, "Ed, you got to do mobile. You got to do mobile. Got to do it." And I said, "Where can we stop and do it? Tell me, when do I, stop doing the other things we're doing and the other marketing we're doing, everything else for our platforms, and really focus on a mobile app?" And so it's time. This is when we need to do it. That's what we're doing. So it's exciting. It's taken us, number of years to get here, but it also enabled me to really perfect this idea, this technology. And so it's a good time. It's a good time to get into it and do it. All right. Okay, no more questions are coming in. So if that is the case, I'll go ahead and leave it for a second here and just see if someone straggles in there with one last one. Okay. And yep. So it's like I say, I looked at a lot of things, and I'm much more comfortable trading with this approach than pick something, because you can see inside the market, and it's just fabulous. All right. Well, I guess with that, we'll go ahead and close the webinar. Again, this is nirvanasystems.com/CTA, and we have the prototype, which I showed you on my phone, working, and it's rendering everything correctly. Now we just need to go to that next step of getting it productized and where it's, we're able to deliver it to a lot of people, and then we'll let everybody know that it's there and how to get it, how to get on your phone, and how to provide feedback to us on it. So we're trying to get that done as quickly as we possibly can. We're looking at the data source that powers it, and there's some that are much less expensive than the typical real-time data source. So we're looking to get the best possible way to drive it right now. That way, the one I showed you was a delay chart, so it needs to be real-time. So there's just things that we're getting kind of closure on with the mobile app, that once we get those things done, then we will release that first version to everyone who's on board, and then just keep going the next iteration, and adding the markets and all those things, notifications and so on. So it's going. Okay, folks, thank you so much for coming today. I really appreciate you, and just wow, let's see what we can do here. It's what we're on. All right, folks, thank you. Take care, and hope you have a great rest of your week, weekend. And good luck in your trading. Market is real back and forth, right? I look at that every day on the NASDAQ, and just, super big rally followed by super big decline. That just seems to be, today it was gap up, followed by immediate turn down really hard and went down for a long ways. So it's the market is just really pulling back and forth. That, of course, that kind of volatility means you're going to get big moves, and it's good. Okay, so we'll close the webinar, but like I say, my first session will be tomorrow morning, and I'll put that in the email that goes out. And anyone who comes on to this evening, I want to encourage you to do that. We'll come to that session, and we'll look at, in live market situation where it's moving, which it really wasn't this afternoon, and work with the app in that situation. Okay, folks, thank you again. Take care, and look forward to seeing you really soon. All right, good night.